Hello friends, welcome to Online Study for You. This is Pratik Srivastava here and our today's topic of discussion is previous year question paper of TCS NQT exam. So please watch out the complete video to understand what kind of questions will come in exam and how we are going to tackle it, right? Okay, so let's start with question number one. Question number one is a very important question. So let's see how do we solve it. If a number is divided by 357, then the remainder is 5. So let's assume the number is n, right? Okay, right. Now if a number is divided by 357, so if you are dividing by 357, then the remainder will be what? The remainder is 5. So suppose you are dividing it by x time and then the remainder is 5, right? Okay, now I will take one simple example so that you will understand the question very much easily. So suppose 13 you are going to divide by 4 times. So this will divide by 3 times, so 3 times it will be 12, and 13 minus 12 will be 1, right? Okay, now I will write here 13 is equals to 4 into 3 plus 1, right? See, 13 will be equal to 4 into 3 plus 1. Now 4 into 3 will be 12, 12 plus 1 will be 13, right? Okay, the similar way I will write here n will be equal to 357 into x plus 5, right? So this was my number actually. So how did I write my number here? So see, basically this we write using the formula. This we write basically using the formula. But if you understand the simple concept, then you can write by yourself. No need of any formula, right? Okay. Now, what has been asked in the question? What will be the remainder if the number is divided by 17? So this number, if you'll divide by 17, then what will be remainder? Now 357, you try to divide it by 17. So if you will try to divide it by 17, then it will go by 21 times. That means this will be completely divisible by 21, right? So this will be completely divisible by 21. So now what will be remaining? 5 will be remaining. And the number which will be remaining, which will become your what? It will become your remainder. And that what has been asked in the question? What will be the remainder if the number is divided by 17? So 5 will be the remainder if it will divided by 17, right? Okay, see, this question we could have done it very easily. Let's see how can we do it. See, what is this number? This number is 357, right? So 357 directly you divide it by 17. So if you will divide 357 by 17, it will go by 21 times, right? Okay, what was the remainder? So the remainder was 5. Now also the remainder will be 5 only, and option C will be the correct answer. So 10 seconds is more than sufficient for this question. But if you want the method, how do we solve it actually, then I have explained it here, right? Okay, let's move to the question number 2. Question number 2 is, what is the next number in the given series? So a series is given, you have to find out the next number. Now what is the series? 7t 54 45 41, and you have to tell the next number, right? Okay, now if you'll see the difference between 70 and 54, then 10 minus 4 is 6 and 6 minus 5 is 1, right? Okay, again if you'll take the difference, then the difference is 9. Again if you'll take the difference, then difference is 4. Now how this difference has been here? See, this is 4 square, this is 3 square, and this is 2 square. So the next difference will be what? 1 square is 1. So the next difference would be 1. So what number should be here? So if you'll keep it 40, then only the difference will be 1, and this 1 square will be what? 1. So this number series, you have to find out a particular pattern in which the series is given. So this pattern was what? The difference of 4 square, the difference of 3 square, the difference of 2 square, and then the difference of 1 square was 1, and that's what we had to find it out. So answer for the question number 2 will be option D, right? Okay, now let's see question number 3. Again one series is given and you have to find out the next number. So what is the series? 11, 23, 47, 83, 131, right? Okay, again you have to find out the next number. So let's see what is the difference. So if you'll see, the difference will be 12 here, the difference will be 7 minus 3 is 4, and 4 minus 2 is 2, 24 here. And then again the difference is 13 minus 7 is 6, and 7 minus 4 is 3, 36. And then the difference is 11 minus 3 is 8, and then 12 minus 8 is 4. So see, the difference is the multiple of 12, right? See, 12 into 1 is equals to 12. Again 12 into 2 will be 24. Again 12 into 3 will be 36. Again 12 into 4 will be 48, right? So the difference is the multiple of 12. 12 into 1, 12 into 2, 12 into 3, 12 into 4. So the next multiple will be 12 into 5, and 12 into 5 will be what? 60. So the next difference would be 60. So if you want difference as 60, then what you'll have to do? 130 plus 60. That means 191. So this number should be 191. Then only the difference you will find is 60, right? So option D will be the correct answer for this question, right? Okay. So in series, there may be more than one or two logic for the same question. We will understand once more. See what may be the other logic for this question, right? Okay. So 131, and then you have to find out the next number. So the difference is 12, the difference is 24. The difference is 36, the difference is 48, right? Okay, take one more time difference. So difference is 12, difference is 12, difference is 12. So in my series, the difference would be again 12. So 48 plus 12 will be what? It should be 60. And if you want 60 difference, then 130 plus 60 will be 191. So this is called two-layer difference. So this is called two-layer difference. So in question of series, there may be more than one, see, one logic here, one logic here. So there may be more than one or two logic, right? So you don't have to, you know, think about that. The logic may be more than one or two. Whatever logic you get, you should be able to get the correct answer, right? Okay. Let's move to the question number four. Question number four is a very important question. Let's see how do we solve it. How many positive integers less than 500 can be formed using the numbers 1, 2, 3 and 5, 4 digit, each digit being used only once. So now some condition has been given in the question, so that you have to keep in mind. See, we have to make how many positive integers less than 500 can be formed, right? Okay, so the first condition is all the positive integers should be less than 500. The second condition is we have to use only four digits, that is 1, 2, 3 and 5, right? So less than 500, if you are making a number 46, which will be wrong, right? Because whatever number positive integers should be less than 500, that should contain only 1, 2, 3 and 5, right? Okay. Now third condition is each digit you have to use only once. Each digit we have to use only once. That means you cannot find a number 5. So because 5 you have to use only once. So 5 and 3 will be a correct combination, right? So each digit you have to use only once, right? Only once. Now we'll see. So how many single digit will be there? How many single digit will be there which will be less than 500 using this number? So 1, 2, 3, 4. So there'll be 4 single digit which will be less than 500 and which will use only these 4 digits, right? Okay. Now we'll see double digit. So how many double digit will be there which will be less than 500, right? Okay. So see, we have 4 options. I can put 4 options here. I can put 5 here. I can put 3 here, I can put 2 here, I can put 1 here. I have 4 options, so all the 4 options I can put here, right? Okay. Now, whatever options I will put, suppose if I am putting 5, then the same 5 we cannot put here, right? Because each digit has to be used only once. So 55 cannot be a number, 53 can be a number. So here we'll have one option less, because here we cannot put the same number whatever we are putting at the first place. So how many double digit number will be there? So 4 into 2, 4 into 3, that means 12 double digit number will be there which will be less than 500 and which will use this 4 digit, right? Okay. Now we'll see the 3 digit numbers. The 3 digit number. So this will be 1, 2 and 3. Now here how many options we have? See, we have 1, 2, 3 and 5. So we have 4 options, but 5 I cannot put here. See, this 5 if I'll put here, that means my number will become more than 500, but they're clearly telling they want the positive integers less than 500, right? Okay. So now how many options we'll have? We'll have 1, 2, 3. So we'll have 3 options here, right? Okay. Now we'll have 3 options. Suppose I have put 2 here. So if I have put 2 here, then how many options I'll have left? 1, 2, 3. So here also I'll have 3. Why? Because 5 I can put at the middle place, but 5 I cannot put at the first place. 5 if I'll put at the first place, then the number will become greater than 500, right? Okay, so here also 3 options, and then we'll have only 2 options. Suppose you put 5 here, then we'll have only 2 options left. So how many 3 digit number? 3 into 3 into 2, which is nothing but 18 3 digit number. So the total is 4 plus 12 plus 18. So 18 plus 12 is 30, 30 plus 4 is 34. So there are total 34 numbers which are less than 500. So there are total 34 positive integers which are less than 500 and which will use 1, 2, 3 and 5, right? Okay. Let's move to the question number 5. Question number 5 is a question of height and distance, which is an important topic for TCS exam, right? Okay. Now, let's read the question and try to solve it here. A tree of height 36 meter is on one edge of a round broke at a certain height. So, suppose this is a 36 meter tree. So, suppose this is a 36 meter tree, right? Okay. Now, they are telling a tree of height 36 meter is on one edge of a road broke at certain height. So, suppose the tree broke at X, right? X height. So, this is the X height and suppose the tree broke here. So, the tree broke at X height. Now, what will be the remaining height of the tree? 36 minus X. See, the total height was, the total height was 36 meter, right? Okay. So, the tree broke at X meter, right? Okay. So, what will be the height of the other tree, whichever has broken, is 36 minus X, right? Okay. Now, it fell in such a way that the top of the tree touches the other edge of the road. See, this is one of the edge of the road, right? And the tree is falling in such a way, see, the broken tree falls in such a way that it touches the other edge of the road. If the breadth of the road is 12 meter, so this is the breadth of the road which is 12 meter, then what is the height at which the tree broke? So basically, you have to find it out the value of X, right? See, after X meter, the tree what? Broke, right? And it is touching the other edge of the road, right? Okay. Now, see, this distance we know X meter, this is 12 meter and the tree which has been broken, the distance is, the height is 36 minus X meter, right? Okay. Now, this is a right angle triangle. Now, this is a right angle triangle and right angle triangle, we know the formula, Pythagoras formula, Pythagoras formula. What is Pythagoras formula? See, if this is your breadth, if this is your length and this is your height, so height will be equal to length square plus breadth square, or I can also say height will be length square plus breadth square. Now height will be what? 36 minus X square. Length will be what? X square plus breadth will be what? 12 square. Now 36 square will be 1296 and minus 72x plus X square will be equal to X square plus 144. X square and X square will get cancelled, and then if you will see 72x will be equal to 1296 minus 144. If you will subtract, then 6 minus 4 is 2 and then 9 minus 4 is 5 and 12 minus 1 is 11, and this will be equal to what? 72x, right? Okay. If you will calculate the value of X, then 1152 divided by 72 will be equal to 16 meter. That means the height of the broken tree, the height of the broken tree will be 36 minus X, that is 36 minus 16 will be 20 meter. But what has been asked in the question? What is the height at which the tree broke? So the tree broke after X meter height, right? So the tree broke after X meter. So the value of X is what? 16 meter. And that's what has been asked in the question. So option D will be the correct answer. The broken tree height will be 20 meter and the height after which the tree broke is 16 meter, right? I hope you understood the complicated height and distance question. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you like the video, then please appreciate my effort by putting a comment in comment box. Thank you.